Hey guys, I'm Geetika and I'm a PhD student at CSAIL. I work on machine learning for healthcare, differential privacy, and I want you to come spend the day with me today. Let's go. Hey, I'm late for work, so let's grab an Uber. In the last couple of years, I've been working on natural language processing approaches in ML for health. And most recently, I got involved with differential privacy. So when I really started my PhD, I'd been working on information extraction approaches, so ways to create structure out of unstructured text. And then I got involved with multimodal machine learning for radiology, where I had the chance to interact with radiologists on a day-to-day, try to understand their decision-making process, and inject some of the learnings that we brought in to the AI models that we were building.
We're here with my advisor, Peter Solovich. This is our one-on-one meeting. We usually meet weekly and we're talking about any progress updates from the last week and also plan to finish the PhD. I'm just talking with Pete about a recent paper we submitted to the conference to get his feedback and also talking about the next steps in terms of the future work that we have planned.
Geetika, you've done a lot of really exciting work in your thesis, but I imagine that when you're giving a job talk, you need to focus it on what's of particular interest to the company. And so you may be giving a number of different talks. In the thesis defense, I think you need to give that greater background, and you also need to focus on one specific thing that you think is the most exciting part of your work.
The job talk that I'm planning for the companies is essentially going to be very similar to the thesis defense slides, but I'll just have to add a little bit more meat in the beginning, the thesis defense slides, to give more background around AI for healthcare, the different applications, and then how I got involved with NLP in healthcare itself. This is my office. This is where I've spent 40 plus hours for the last 5+ years. And it's really been a journey to get here. When I was a kid, I was really excited about math and computer science. And it was my passion for computer science that got me to do an undergraduate degree there. And I had great mentorship and really great research experiences that got me involved in AI. And finally, I made it to MIT, which I can't believe I'm here every day still. But I get to do this and I get to follow my passion every day, which is exciting. The PhD can be a stressful experience sometimes. Your paper might not get into the conference that you want. You might change your research direction. And you overall just need to establish yourself as a good researcher in the field. One of the ways I like to decompress is hang out with my friends and my community of fellow researchers in CSAIL. And sometimes I hang out with my friends' dogs. Another place that's really nice for me to come and work is actually this lounge. We have open spaces in CSAIL like these all over the place. And we have these really nice phone booths where you can take calls from. And overall, I love changing up my pace of the place I'm working from, and also helps me be really productive in my work and my day-to-day life.
Cambridge and MIT are really fun places to live in. I live in the Sydney Pacific graduate community, which is the largest dorm at MIT. And we have monthly events organized by other students, great chance to meet with others and socialize. We also have professors who live in the building who are always there to support and guide us. And an aspect of life I'm really looking forward to is graduating, getting a job, and seeing my research being translated into products and seeing it being applied in everyday life. All right, I don't know about you guys, but I'm looking forward to some coffee, so let's go.
All right, I got my coffee fix. So let's go back to talking about the PhD. So you guys might not be aware, but you're actually able to do summer internships during the PhD program. I had 3 wonderful summers where I got the chance to collaborate with different companies, met up with some really smart people, got the chance to see my research being translated into practice, and sometimes publish papers with them. As far as the day-to-day life of a PhD student in computer science, you're going to be coding a lot of the times. If you're in machine learning, you might be running a lot of models. You are going to be reading some papers based on the domain that you're in. And you want to inform your own research based on what others are working on. So you want to be aware of the literature. Based on that, you're going to be publishing papers, presenting those at conferences, meeting up with new collaborators, and also getting the chance to meet up with new people. So it's a lot of dynamic day-to-day work, which is a lot of fun. Speaking of presentations, I have a presentation to give to my group today about my recent paper. So would you guys like to join me?
So now you guys are gonna see me give a presentation. This is just part of work that I did at my internship last year and wanted to get your guys' feedback because I'm planning on giving a job talk about this soon. I'll start with a brief overview of the PhD research in ML NLP for healthcare and then go more into the differential privacy work.
Thank you so much for spending the day with me at MIT CSIL and learning more about my work in machine learning for health and differential privacy. I'll catch you guys next time.